Hello, good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Welcome to Prince Miller Entertainment TV channel. Subscribe to the channel. Follow us on Twitter at @PMillerENT. We are on Instagram at @PrinceMillerEntertainment. Available on our Facebook account, Prince Miller Entertainment. Welcome to another edition of Daily News on Breaking News. So the Zimbabwean crisis, United Nations steps in. The United Nations says it is following the Zimbabwean crisis with concern, urging Harare to respect human rights amid pressure for the matter to be tabled at the global meeting. United Nations Secretary General Antonio Guterres, through his office, said the President Emmerson Mnangagwa's administration should protect fundamental rights as opposed to what has been happening in the Southern African country in the last weeks. He urged the government of Zimbabwe to ensure the protection of all fundamental human rights, notably the freedom of opinion and expression and the right to freedom of peaceful assembly and association. A statement from Guterres' office read in part, in recent months, dozens of Zimbabweans have been abducted, arrested, tortured, while many have been forced into hiding, including MDC Alliance Vice Chairperson Job Sikala. Journalists, lawyers, doctors and nurses have also not been spared. The United Nations Human Rights Commission last week also created anger to increase cases of human rights abuse in Zimbabwe, with its spokesperson Liz Throssell saying citizens should not be persecuted for protesting peacefully. South Africa on Thursday reacted to pressure from Zimbabweans, with President Cyril Ramaphosa sending envoys to Harare to deal with the crisis. Ramaphosa seconded former Secretary Minister Sydney Mufamandi and former Vice President Baleka Mbete to engage the government of Zimbabwe and relevant stakeholders to identify possible ways in which South Africa can assist Zimbabwe. The South African leader said he took the decision following recent reports of difficulties that Zimbabwe is experiencing. However, the appointment of the two raised eyebrows amid reports that Mbete was Mnangagwa's personal friend who helped him settle temporarily in South Africa after he was fired as vice president by the late former president Robert Mugabe in November 2017. Mnangagwa fled to South Africa claiming there were threats on his life, and in his narration of events he said, "Mbete is a good friend of mine, so she came to where I was hiding and she told President Jacob Zuma that I was there." South African opposition leader Musi Amemane and said Mbete's brother was South African ambassador to Zimbabwe and has remained quiet despite a glaring crisis. Maimane called for an inclusive team to act on the Zimbabwean crisis. SAR ambassadors to Harare, Mpakama Mbete, is Mbaleka Mbete's brother. He has been quiet during the arrest of journalists. Sidney Mufanandi did not speak to opposition in 2007. Rather than a shame envoy, we need a robust envoy with representatives from the Economic Freedom Fighters, United Democratic Movement, UDM, Democratic Alliance, and Inkatha Freedom Party. My man said this was not time for friends to have a tea in the midst of a crisis. We can't be having friends having tea while the following happens: investigative journalists are arrested, activists are silenced, opposition victimized. My man said UDM leader Mbatu Holomisa said it was now time for SADC to intervene and rescue Zimbabwe into a peaceful country after several years of human rights abuses and fighting. "It is time for SADC to intervene in Zimbabwe to help them find solutions, reconciliation and peace. Things can't go on like this, he said. The protests, abductions of government critics and its neighboring countries continue to be affected as Zimbabweans keep fleeing their country in search of safety and relief from their economic circumstances. As matters stand, the UDM calls on SADC to intervene and assist Zimbabweans to find a solution to the crisis intensifying in the country. A call for Zimbabwean crisis to be discussed at next week's SADC Heads of State Summit to be held virtually and hosted by Mozambique have grown louder as the region remains convinced that the country is in a mess. South Africa said it was concerned by reports of rights violations in Zimbabwe, and its international relations minister, Nalendi Panda, on Tuesday engaged his Zimbabwean counterpart, Sibusiso Moyo, over the issue. The Harare crisis has hosted international spotlight with the hashtag Zimbabweans. So guys, the United Nations, you know, they've said something about the hashtag Zimbabweans Lives Matter. You know, I did tell you some few days ago that this hashtag has been reaching so many people, you know, and celebrities all over the world, you know, my organizations like Rwanda, and including now United Nations. So they are saying, you know what, Mnangagwa needs to, you know, respect human rights and it ends. Pachatwa meeting UN Global Summit, Zimbabwe shall be one of the topics and it got to be discussed on that meeting. So, you know, the hashtag is actually working, and you know, I just want to thank, you know, Munwese aka Twitter hashtag Zimbabwe Lives Matter. You know, we are now reaping the rewards, but the journey still continues because we still want the Zimbabwean government to, you know, to respond, you know, by action. As long as we go to our chat, no, but we want action on the ground, you know, we want a reality. So Zimbabwe kuna crisis, yeah, what's on the net is not what's my streets, you know. You guys, we just need to shut up for real. In Zimbabwe there's a crisis. We all know kuti my journalists are kusungwa, you know, a health sector, akuna ma doctors, akuna ma nurses, and you guys, they are saying that akuna crisis with Zimbabwe, you know. So people need to understand what a crisis is. We are in a crisis. Kurarama kukuta wanu Zimbabwe at the moment, it's not normal, it's abnormal. And kuda kurarama life is normal. And so, you know, people have been reacting positively, you know, on this article. People have been saying, thank God, at least it has reached a fever peak point of no return, where no one can bribe, not this SADC African leaders who endorse brutality because some of their business interests. We need action, not just talk. This government is actually a big threat to the Zimbabwean people than COVID-19. That's true. We need action. You know, it's not time to go to Zoni. We need to have press conferences and stuff, or a press release, or a press statement. And let's hope with the UN we intervene into the situation which is happening in our country, which is Zimbabwe. And government here, Zimbabwe, proper. They must do things proper. So guys, do you think Zoni UN intervening into Zimbabwe is no one's a change here? Can I So guys, talk to me in the comment section. And remember, our videos are now available on our Instagram accounts, also on our Facebook accounts. It's our Prince Miller Entertainment. Subscribe to the channel, guys. You know, the situation of hashtag Zimbabwe Lives Matter, we continue following. We continue giving you guys up to date. I always keep you guys up to date. And please, you know, we should not prosecute misread, and misread, and she also apologized and say sorry for that interview, I also explain more about the situation. You know, I feel good munemuno anima views yake, and we should not prosecute munhu kana kumtuka kana kum body shaming just because ataura zvinhu zvanongosingavirirane nazvo. You know, on this channel I always say kuti let's respect each other's views. Let's kasatukane nekuti mumwe munhu anosupport the other side, or mumwe munhu anemafumonero ake anenge akasiyana nemaonero anongochita wewe. Guys, this is a daily news on breaking news. Thank you for listening. Bless up. Happy Sunday.